Hi guys, and welcome back to Ask a Lawyer channel. Hope you are all having a great day. Were you waiting for new stories from Ask a Lawyer? I have three new ones for you today. Let's go to the first one, about a sister-in-law who announces her pregnancy during OP's wedding. By the way, she is only 3 weeks pregnant. Enjoy the stories, guys, and don't forget to like and subscribe. And of course, don't forget to leave a comment. Okay, so a bit of background. My husband's brother is a 22-year-old in his last year of college, and 8 months ago met a 32-year-old woman who already had a 17-year-old. We were all a little skeptical of her because she's not been allowing my once very sociable brother-in-law out with his friends, and even to meet us. On top of that, she'd only been dating him for a few months before she convinced him to drop out of college, as studying for college meant that he couldn't spend enough time with her. She's also paid for him to get her and her daughter's name tattooed on his chest. She is well known as a compensation queen. In the 8 months we've known her, she successfully sued 5 different businesses for money because of something very, very minor, like she was in their store and she supposedly cut herself on the cart, which causes emotional damage. I am polite and friendly to her, but I don't like her. It was my wedding at the weekend, and at the start of the ceremony, before I'd even walked down the aisle, she stood up at the pastor's mic and announced that she was pregnant. I walked down the aisle less than 5 minutes later, unknowing, but my husband's family and my husband looked very shook up. My mother-in-law later told me that she had so much going through her mind that she could barely enjoy the wedding, as such a bombshell had just been sprung on her. My husband kept tripping over his vows because, as he said, I was just in absolute shock that what had just happened. She made the reception all about her. In pictures, she was holding her belly like she was just about to pop. She went around everyone at the reception to discuss her news with them also. The best is, she was only 3 weeks pregnant, and only knew because she'd taken one of those clear blue tests. Some extended family members, who don't know what the situation is and how we are all very worried about my brother-in-law, were congratulating her before me. I know I sound jealous, but I just feel so upset that she tried to steal my day after all the expense and planning that went into it. Grumble, grumble. I know I can't change it now, but how do I deal with a sister-in-law, not married yet, like this? Especially one that's going to have my only niece or nephew. Thanks for all your time. Just because she's dating OP's brother-in-law doesn't mean OP has to deal with or see her. She sounds nuts. Hopefully their relationship will implode, and OP will just have an idiot brother-in-law to deal with. OP doesn't sound jealous at all. That's a seriously messed up thing to do. I wouldn't order any pictures from the photographer that she's in. I and my fiancé have been together for 6 years, engaged for about 8 months, and our wedding is scheduled for November. It's been a good, solid relationship from the beginning. We have great chemistry and have similar interests and principles. We are both doing well in our careers, have been saving money for our wedding and the down payment for our future house. I'm going to try and keep the rest chronological, but there's a lot that I don't know. My fiancée, let's call her Beth, was best friends through school and university with Sonia, that is, for about 8 years. But then Sonia started dating a foreign student in their university, and they got serious really quickly and got married within 6 months of dating. After their course was over, Sonia moved with him back to his home country and basically cut out Beth from her life. All of this happened before I met Beth. And from what she told me, she was devastated when it happened. She would try to contact Sonia for years after and be totally ignored. And the hurt remained. Around last Christmas, Sonia came back to the UK and moved in with her parents. It was Sonia's mom who told Beth about her return. This happened in January. Beth went up to her parents during Easter, and since Sonia and her family were from the same town, she tried to meet Sonia as well. The reunion did not go really well. Turns out, Sonia's now ex-husband was extremely controlling and emotionally abusive, and it took her a lot of effort to divorce and then move back home. Sonia was still recovering and would lash out at everyone, including Beth. When Beth got back home, she told me about it. She was deeply hurt and cried a lot. A lot of nasty things were said to her because Sonia blamed everyone in her life for her terrible relationship with her ex. Special anger was reserved for Beth, since she was around when she first started dating her ex, and she should have somehow seen signs of the guy being the evil one he turned out to be. Beth still wanted to rekindle their friendship, and they would write to each other a lot. There were ups and downs, but over a couple of months, they did get back to a semblance of their old friendship. I and Beth went on a vacation in mid-June. 3 days before we were about to leave, Beth invited Sonia and she agreed to join us. I found out about this the day before we were leaving and it annoyed me a lot. Firstly, the main reason we were going on this trip was because me and Beth were going to be really busy with work for the next few months, and we needed to spend some time with each other, especially because there's going to be a lot of wedding stress coming up. And I was also annoyed because now I had to spend 2 weeks with someone who I had never met before, someone for whom my empathy was tempered by the fact that she was needlessly hurtful to my fiancé. We arrived at a compromise. Sonia would join us for the first week of the vacation, and Beth and me would have the second week to ourselves. From what Beth told me, Sonia was ticked off by that and almost canceled. But she didn't, and the trip was a disaster from the beginning. We met at the airport, and after a frosty hello, she simply talked to Beth the whole time. Any small talk that I attempted was rebuffed with monosyllabic responses or just shrug. When Sonia would need to tell me something, she would talk to Beth, with me sitting right there. Like when she needed to go to the bathroom and I was sitting on the aisle seat, she turned to Beth and said, "Can you tell that guy to move? I need to pee." Later in the hotel, when me and Beth went to get Sonia for lunch, she told her, "Tell that guy I'll just have room service." I was the one who asked the question and I was standing right there. Worst was during the nights. Sonia said she didn't want to sleep alone and she didn't want to share a room with us, so Beth would sleep in Sonia's room and I would be alone. Beth wasn't happy about this behavior either and told me that Sonia is very uncomfortable around men in general, so I should just give her a wide berth. Then when I did that for a day, Beth came back to me and said that Sonia finds it very rude the way I've been ignoring her. I genuinely didn't know what to do. It ended up being me sitting around them while I was not included in their conversation, and any conversation that I would try to have was shot down by Sonia. Beth would try and smooth things out, but she was also caught in an uncomfortable position. It all came to a head on the second to last day of Sonia's time with us. Beth has always wanted to go parasailing, and our vacation spot was chosen specifically for a parasailing spot nearby, which is supposed to be one of the most scenic ones in Europe. Sonia refused to join us, of course. But then when we got to the spot, Sonia's mom called Beth and said that she just had a very worrying phone call with Sonia where she talked about S. So we rushed back, calling Sonia all the way back to the hotel. When she didn't pick up multiple calls, we called the hotel to check up on her for emergency reasons. Sonia was just fine. She told the hotel guys that her friends were just paranoid, and she told us that her mom was paranoid and she wasn't actually talking about committing S, just talking about S in general. Beth was fuming and they had an awful row. I found out two things during this row. Firstly, that Sonia was extremely manipulative, even in the old days, and that she had forced Beth to pay for her tickets and hotel room. While there was no real resolution to their argument, they stayed civil for the one day that Sonia was there afterwards. It was just us awkwardly watching TV in silence in our hotel rooms. Thankfully, the non-Sonia part of our vacation was beautiful. While we didn't get to go parasailing again, you have to book at least 30 days in advance. We still had a great time doing all sorts of things, and I've never felt more in love with Beth than that week. Beth also came to the resolution that she was going to take a step back from her friendship with Sonia for a while, at least till she apologizes for her behavior and pays Beth back. That resolution did not last long. We got back to London on the 23rd of June, and Beth left for her parents on the 27th without telling me. I walked into our empty flat and called her, only to find out that she was rethinking our relationship and wanted some time to herself and that she would get in touch with me later. I was completely devastated. I had no inkling that this was on the cards, and since Beth wasn't taking my calls or responding to my messages, I called Beth's mom, and she tells me that Beth isn't staying with them, but with Sonia. So not only did she break her own resolution, Beth also lied to me. The next time we spoke was on the 1st of this month when our rent was due, and I texted her that she needs to send her half to the landlord. She called me and said that though she'll send her share this month, she will also give her 1 month notice to remove herself from the lease. And that's how I found out that my fiancé had decided to become my ex-fiancé. I asked her why she was doing something this drastic without giving us a chance to resolve whatever the problem was. She said she was going to send me an email detailing everything, and that she had talked to her parents about this, and they also thought that it was right for us to break up. I told her that I had talked to her mom earlier in the day and knew that she hadn't been in any sort of contact with her parents since she got to her hometown. Beth was extremely angry that I would talk to her mom and that it was very creepy to call a girl's mom. I said that it would be creepy if it was a random stranger, but when it's your fiancé who left without any notice and then refuses to talk to you, calling their parents is the obvious thing to do. An angry back and forth happened till, finally, she admitted that she was with Sonia and she didn't want to tell me because she knew I was going to be annoyed about it and talk her out of it. On Monday, I finally get that email and it's a total pile of shite. The main thing she says is that I'm controlling and that she can't spend the rest of her life with a guy like that. She used three different examples of my controlling behavior. The vacation we just had, where I forced her and Sonia to go to all these museums and mountains that they didn't want to go to. Complete and utter BS. Beth has a degree in European history, and these are places that she had never visited before that play a big role in that history. Also, the fact that Beth had researched and found some of these places and bought tickets with literally no input from me. That we'll be having a church wedding even though she isn't really religious and doesn't want to do that. Again, complete and utter BS. I had literally no say in the choice of venue, and the fact that the church that was chosen is the one that Beth's parents were married in might give a hint as to who chose that place. That I shoot down all her proposals about flats that we might buy after the wedding, and that I refuse to move to her hometown. This one is by far the weirdest. She has never made any proposals about flats that we might buy, mainly because we don't even know what our budget will be until after the wedding expenses are dealt with. Also, she has never stated any desire to move back to her hometown, especially considering that her career is very much London-based and would be improbable in her town. I sent my reply to her along these lines, less curtly and with a lot more pleading, of course. I received no reply until last night when she said she has come to the realization that her parents are also very controlling and that she has decided to be low contact with them. Her parents are wonderful people who have loved and supported Beth through thick and thin. That is what Beth has said to me all through our relationship until last night. There's something massively wrong with Beth, and Sonia has been a catalyst. This part I'm sure about. Because this morning, I got a text from Sonia saying that whatever I may need to say to Beth has to go through her, and that I should refrain from contacting Beth directly or they would go to the police. Me and Beth's parents had a conversation earlier today, and they want to go to the police about Sonia. I'm not sure about that. It's been less than 20 days since me and Beth were snuggling and talking about what to name our future kids. I don't know whether I'm delusional or not, but I think this is just something temporary, and she'll snap out of it soon. I don't even know what I will say to the police. That Beth has been kidnapped by this tiny 5-foot woman who's brainwashed her into believing everyone else in her life is abusive and controlling? I know that Beth still picks up her own calls. Maybe if she doesn't hang up as soon as she hears my voice, I might be able to talk to her. But what do I say that might make a difference? I'm very, very tired of all of this. Haven't slept more than 2 hours a night since she left. I want to talk to her all the time, but I have to hold myself back and not come across as the controlling person that I supposedly am. Any help or advice is appreciated. I don't know if you will agree with me, guys, but first thing that came into my mind is that Beth is in love with Sonia. I can't find any other explanation for her behavior, to be honest. Sonia and Beth have some weird thing going on between them that is clearly putting them into a very unhealthy mental state. I am sure there was something between them before that the parents either ignored or didn't tell OP. I think OP didn't know his fiancé as well as he thought he does. It's obvious he is in love with Beth, is super invested, and so has been excusing her the whole way. But this is not the way a fiancé who's been with you for 6 years should be treating you on account of an old and, by all accounts, crappy friend. This goes far beyond Sonia's manipulation abilities. I'm sure Beth is not the woman OP thinks she is. And to be honest, I think OP will dodge a huge bullet here. So, my fiancé and I moved to a small town on the East Coast about 3 years ago. We didn't know anyone, and it was quite far away from our family back west. We have two children, a girl who is 5 and a boy who is 7. Our closest neighbor was an older man who I will call Tom. I found out from someone else that Tom's wife and daughter died in a car crash some years ago. We felt bad for him. So we invited him to a barbecue, and he's been a staple in our lives ever since. He is basically the sweetest man ever. My kids adore him. My father's parents are dead, and my mom's are the most uninvolved people you could meet, so Tom has become a replacement grandpa. He has a huge backyard, and he and my fiancé built the kids a treehouse in it. They often go there after school. He cooks for them. He took our son fishing. He made our daughter a little dollhouse. He's just great. He clearly has so much love to give. And my fiancé gets on great with him too. They often have a beer on the porch and chat about life. We have dinner together all the time. He feels like the father I never had. It almost feels like fate that we became neighbors. I got the idea of asking Tom to walk me down the aisle at my wedding in July. My real father and I have a friendly relationship, but he's kind of a drifter. Him and my mom split when I was small, and I barely saw him. He likes to travel the world. He sent some money and called and sent gifts and cards and stuff, but he didn't fulfill the role of a dad. He's currently living in Thailand. He's not 100% sure if he'll make it to the wedding. When I told him my idea of asking Tom to walk me down the aisle, he gave me the okay. So I asked Tom if he would like to do it. He accepted and said that these past couple of years have been his happiest in a long time. He cried. I cried. Then my mother cried when I called to tell her, but not in a good way. My mom was raised super traditional. She was a good, loving mother, but she struggled with her family and acquaintances who criticized her for having a child with someone undependable like my father. She tries to hide it, but I know fine well this has been a sore spot for her. I've told her to ignore catty relatives, etc., but she doesn't listen. And when I told her about Tom walking me down the aisle, she broke down. You can't let a strange man that isn't your father walk you down the aisle. What will various relatives think? Note: for the past 2 years, Tom has sent her Christmas cards and cookies, and she has sent him cards and gifts too. They haven't met yet, but spoke on the phone and got along very well. She was borderline hysterical. I get that it's her old issues with being judged coming back to haunt her, but I don't know how to talk to her. She even said she didn't want to come to the wedding. Also note that all these judgy relatives that I've invited, I invited for her because she wanted them there. I know how it sounds, crazy mom getting controlling about her daughter's wedding, but I have to stress that this is so out of character for her. This is a woman who despises tattoos, but forced a smile and said, "lovely colors," when I showed her mine. She tries her damn hardest to be loving. She's done a lot for me, and I'm at a loss now because it's been 2 weeks and she's barely talking to me over what is, to me, a really lovely and positive thing. I also can't imagine not having her at my wedding. How do I talk to her? I don't understand why the mom is not okay if even the dad is. Probably OP's mother reacted like this because she took it very personal. If she has been hurt in the past by her relatives judging her choice of partner, then OP choosing a stranger to walk you down the aisle will feel to her like a final public humiliation, showing to everyone how bad her choice was. Seems like she still has an open wound from the past. I think OP made a wonderful choice. I think the relationship OP and her family have with their neighbor is the sweetest thing. He's family. Honestly, I know this is easier said than done, but it's OP's wedding. She makes the decisions and people have to live with them. Maybe OP should let her mom cool down a bit, then talk to her again, explaining how important it is for her to be walked by Tom down the aisle. Hopefully she'll come around.